We have discussed in a previous class about the first Anglo-Maratha war, second Anglo-Maratha war. Now we shall discuss about and continue the third Anglo-Maratha war. See, that is begin from 1817 and end with 1818. The Peshwa attacked the British residency in Pune and burned it down. Here, the Peshwa also became very bored and disappointed. So he immediately attacked on the British residency at Pune and immediately it also burnt it down. So when the Peshwa attacked the British Pune, that is the residency, and also burnt down, they became very angry against the Peshwa. So Appa Sahib of Nagpur and Malhar Rao Holkar rebel against the British. So here the Peshwa's chieftain start rebel against the British. Particularly Appa Sahib Nagpur and Malhar Rao Holkar from this place against the British and were suppressed ruthlessly. But they became defeated by the Britishers. Finally, Peshwa Bajirao II fought against the British at Gurgaon. Bajirao II also rebelled against the British because they became united. At Gurgaon, attacked by the Bajirao II against the British and Asti and later surrendered to the British. So this time the British surrendered. Britishers made the surrender to the Marathas chieftains. So they covered by all directions to the Marathas. So Marathas became surrendered to the Britishers. So the British abolished the Peshwa court. When Peshwa fought against the British, so immediately defeated them and the Peshwa surrendered with them. So immediately abolished the Peshwa court by the British and granted pension to Bajirao II. Bajirao defeated him by the British and also gave the pension and abolished the Peshwa court by the British here. The instead of Pratap Simha, the descendant of Shivaji, so immediately thrown the Pratap Simha that court and descendant of Shivaji as the ruler of Satara, and misculpted the name him as the traditional leader of Marathas and suppressed the Maratha resistance. So the Pratap Simha supported to the British. The British took the support from the Pratap Simha and thrown it to him and get the help from him and assigned to him to suppress the Maratha resistance here by the British to the Pratap Simha. So the consolidation of the British power. So how the Britishers consolidate their power in India from 1818 to 1857? See, the British compelled their agenda of ruling the entire India from 1818 to 1857. They have full power taken by Britishers from the provincial kings in India, and they occupied major states like Sindh, Awadh and many other smaller states also. Next, the Anglo-Sikh wars also happened here. Here the Britishers defeated all chieftains of Marathas, Mysoreans, Chittagong Sultan, everybody also, and last one the Sikhs also. See, a political anarchy broke out in Punjab after the death of King Ranjit Singh in 1839. So during that time, the Ranjit Singh became deaf in 1839. The post of king problem created there. So that time I am captured by the Britishers here. That is the Punjab. The after the death of King Ranjit Singh in 1839, the political anarchy also happened more at Punjab. See the picture of Ranjit Singh. The British attempted to invade Punjab. Britishers immediately attempted to Punjab and the Ranjit Singh become there. The wallet is the continuous friendship that they had with the rest of the king. So they have continuously attacked to the Punjab and he was Ranjit Singh become dead. In December 1847, a war broke out between the British and Punjab immediately. In 1845, the war happened between British and Punjab king. Sensing the danger from an outside force, Hindus, Sikhs and Muslims got together to defeat the British. Immediately, the Hindus and Muslims and Sikhs also come under the one unity and tried to fight against the British here. But finally, they had to accept defeat to few traitor leaders. They become suppressed by the British here and defeated by British here. But they signed a humiliating Lahore Agreement in 1846. 1846, the Lahore Agreement also happened between them. So that made them the humiliation. If the British president became the de facto ruler of Punjab, that is Lahore Agreement happened 1846 by British and Sikhs. Like this, Punjab became the dependent state of East India Company immediately. Then they became defeated by the British. The Punjab also dependent by the state of East India Company. The Sikh opposed the attempt by the British to rule Punjab directly. Now, but the Punjab king, they wanted to rule over the Punjab by them. But that opportunity is not given by the Britishers. Here, that is the resident. The opposition was led by Chhatar Singh Atharwaya, Atharwala. So here they started the protest against British by the Chhatar Singh Atharwala in Lahore and also Mudraj in Mutha. So both the leaders of Sikhs start against the British rule here, and again the people of Punjab were defeated. So they were also become defeated by the Britishers. Here, Lord Dalhousie, see, merged the state of Punjab into the British Empire. So, here, Chhatar Singh Atharwala and also Mudraj from Multan, both fought against the Lord Dalhousie, but Lord Dalhousie, which in a company, defeated both them and gained victory. So, the Punjab also comes under the power of British rule in India. Dalhousie and the doctrine of lapse. See, Dalhousie introduced the doctrine of lapse here. What is doctrine of lapse? See, that the doctrine of lapse introduced in 1848. Dalhousie, who arrived in India as a governor general and attempted to integrate Indian princely state into the British Empire. The Dalhousie introduced 1848, that is called doctrine of lapse. What is doctrine of lapse? Those who are native ruler do not have any male heir or male child. That kingdom left to the Britishers. Adopted child do not have any right to the king of his father. So that is called the doctrine of lapse. See, these are all the places comes under the control of Britishers under the doctrine of lapse. See, he adopted doctrine of lapse policy, or by the adopted children of Indian king were refused to have their right to throne. So, any adopted child do not have any right of the king asset. So, Lord Dalhousie, the governor general from 1848 to 1856, devised the doctrine. It stated that a kingdom could be annexed if the king died without a male heir. Without a male heir, the kingdom lapsed to the British, not to the adopted child. So, many kingdoms were annexed. Satara, Sambalpur, Satara in 1848, Sambalpur 1815, Udaipur 1852, Nagpur 1853, Jhansi 1854, Awadh 1856. So, in this year, these are all the provincial states comes under the control of British rule by the doctrine of lapse policy. So, according to this policy, if any Indian ruler dies without children, their adopted children had no legal right over the throne. Adopted children, they have not any legal right to the throne. So, and such state gets merged with the British Empire. As per these rules, some of the places comes under the British rule. See here, Satara, Nagpur, Sambalpur, Udaipur, Jhansi and Jaipur. So these are all the provincial states comes under the control of Britishers. Satara, Jhansi, Sambalpur, Udaipur and also Jhansi and Jaipur. So these are all the Nagpur also comes under the control of totally six provincial states comes under the control of British rule by the doctrine of lapse policy adopted by the or introduced by the Lord of Housing. See, with the severe implementation of this policy, not only the princely families, even ordinary people who sympathetic to their king's rebel against the so the kings not only rebel against the ordinary people also become angry against the British rule in India. So they start rebelled against the British by the doctrine of lapse policy. So their love for their kings and the sense of loyalty fueled this rebellion further. So this finally resulted in the Sipahi Mutiny in 1857. So the important causes for the 1857 revolt, that is also one of the political causes. Introduced the cunning group policy, doctrine of lapse and subsidiary alliance. So these are all important reasons due to the 1857 revolt. So last one question, how many wars did the English fight against the 6 to annex Punjab? There are 2 wars against the 6 to annex Punjab. Last one. Here, what policy did Dalhousie adopted to integrate Indian princely state into the British Empire? See, Dalhousie adopted the doctrine of lapse policy to integrate Indian princely state into the British Empire by the Lord of Housing. So, these are all the provincial states comes under the control of British rule. Already I have discussed that points and everything. Also, the chapter will be completed. Thank you. I will come back next class in new lesson.